Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Meg, and if you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. So, I got tagged by Ron from Ramirofi, to talk about the flaws of my designer bags. And yeah, now most of my bags are secondhand, so I wouldn't talk about like flaws that are caused by wear and tear. Okay, I think the only new bags that I have are my bags from Coach, because well, I can't afford to buy new, but with like all the other luxury designer bags, I'm like pre-loved, man. Anyway, I'll start with this guy here, which is my Saint Laurent biker bucket bag in calfskin leather. There you go. I really like the look of this because, I mean, if you can't tell, it looks like a biker jacket. Like, it even has this buckles on here, like how you have it on like the belt loops. So what do I think are the flaws in this bag? Now, let's take out the filler in there. This bag has a tendency to flop down, and I think most leather bags do. As the leather soften, that's just the nature of the beast. But what I don't really like about this bag is, one, it doesn't have any internal pockets. It's just a big black hole in there. There's no organization whatsoever in there. I'm actually planning on getting a custom made bag organizer for it. Just so I don't have to put this, because this is actually a bed sheet. But it's the only thing that I have is big enough that would be able to like hold it up, right? But also, I am not the biggest fan of what they used as the drawstring here. It's made of rolled leather, and it's got like those silver ends to keep it intact, but it's just not very easy to close it like that. And to be honest, I never wear it closed anyway. And when you pull it down, it's like it's really long. I don't like how it like flaps around like that. So I'm actually, and it's also not the easiest to adjust the straps. But I used to wear this as a shoulder bag or even crossbody, but because of the size, it just came really bulky. And I was even contemplating on letting it go. But after I realized that I could actually carry it more of a tote bag instead of, let's show you that. More of a tote bag like this instead of a crossbody or a shoulder bag, then I decided to keep it. But really, this one kind of annoys me. I am not a fan of that. Yeah, I think it would have been better if they had a thinner leather drawstring than this. So I usually would just tie that like a knot and then put the ends inside, and I just carry it like that. Now the pockets on these are functional. They have purpose. They're deep enough for you to be able to put stuff in it, so that's absolutely fine with me, and I like it that way. So if I was wanting to carry a big bag, I remember I was eyeing the Celine Soul Sangle, but because of Emma Hill and Kenny Fortaleza. But when I decided to wear this more as a tote, then I was like, oh, I don't need that bag anymore because this fits the bill. Yeah, so the only thing is that there is no internal organization, so I am gonna just have to get a organizer for it. KD Australia allows you to order custom-made ones, so I'm probably gonna get them to make one for me. Yeah, so that's that. So it is for me more of a design flaw rather than a manufacturing flaw, all right? Here, this one, my Chanel 19, I mean, I remember having this conversation with Kenny and we were talking about, and I could not unsee it, the black one that's got obviously the gold hardware. It looks like there's a spider on there. So I thought I'm never gonna get the black one. But when I saw this color, this is the dark beige small Chanel 19, and I saw this on Vessier. It already has a little mark there. I don't know if you can tell, but it's probably my fingernails that's caused that. Good thing with lambskin is sometimes you can actually buff it off. Anyway, it's so soft, it's so buttery. My gripe on this one is that I wished there. So look at the chain here. Okay, the chain. I would actually have preferred it to not have this leather bit here because, I don't know, it has, I don't know, I just feel like I would prefer that it was just the chain, like how the classic flaps are. And I also don't like how it's uneven. Like, when I say uneven, like, you got your gold all the way through here, and then from there, you've got your ruthenium, I guess, all the way there, and then you got and a little bit of the shiny silver on that part there, and then another shiny silver here. I wish that they'd done this like gold here to there, and then the ruthenium here to there, and then the rest of it would be the shiny silver, like, you know what I mean, to have a little bit of symmetry, because the OC in me, just, I don't know, that I don't like that. Again, and one other thing, now I don't know if all the Chanel flaps are like this, the Chanel 19s are like this, but mine, the pocket here, this has actually got a magnet there to magnetic closure or clasp, and the magnet on this one is so freaking strong. Like, I've seen some people, they just do a little bit of that and it'll open. Mine is like, you need to exert a lot of effort. I hope you heard that. Like, and I'm so scared that because of how strong the magnet is, that it's just gonna come off and tear the leather. That's how strong it is. So I actually have like a car park card here, and I put it between the magnets, so that it doesn't actually hook on properly, because I'm really scared that it's gonna damage the bag, right? It might have been just this, I don't know. I haven't seen other people have that same issue. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. See, now this kind of design I prefer over the classic flap without the second flap, because that's just an annoyance to me. Right, and I always store it with bubble wrap inside to keep the shape. So anyway, I'll fix that later. Now this isn't a designer bag. This is from Handbag Craze, but when you see it, you'll think, oh, is that a Kelly? this is by Handbag Craze. This is their Ava 25. Very reminiscent of a Kelly 25, right? Now, my gripe on this is more on the handle. Well, first of all, it's a very solid handle that if you're wearing it crossbody, that's actually gonna hit you on the sides. But also, this has a very finicky opening. So you've got to twist this part, unlatch this two, and then you open the flap, right? So in this case, if I wanted to carry it by the top handle, I can't really keep it open like that. So when I wear it crossbody, I just leave it open like that because it's fine, right? But if I want to carry it then it kind of like goes like that as I'm walking, because the handle is on the flap. I know like the Birkin one has got it on the back here and on the front here, right? So it doesn't impact whether the bag is closed or not. And I wouldn't be like carrying this closed all the time because it's just annoying to get in and out of. Like, even when I put this on there, that means that the opening is quite small. So I'll need to leave it open if I wanted to be able to go in and out of the bag, right? And I'm actually glad that I bought this dupe for the Kelly, because imagine if I bought an actual Hermes for like $10,000+, and I would be annoyed by the fact that I can't, it's not a practical bag, right? So yeah, I'm very glad I didn't spend that much money. This was like under 300 Australian dollars. So I'm totally fine with spending that money on this rather than saving up for a real Hermes and then finding out later that I would be annoyed by the fact that the opening is not practical and that the handles are not what I want them to be. Right, because when you close it, it cinches this part here, right? So it makes the opening much more narrower. But don't you just love how cute it is? And it's got feet. Anyway, next, this is my Chloe Paddington bag, which I got for $50 at a fancy flea market, and it turned out to be authentic. I had it authenticated. Really nice bag, really beautiful leather, fits a lot of things. I'm actually gonna keep this now in place of my Chanel classic flap. I mean, if you've watched the previous video, you would know why I'm letting this one go. But anyway, here we go. The thing that I don't like about this is how heavy this padlock is. It's almost like if you take this off, it'll be half the weight. This is an empty bag and it's still very heavy without anything in it. So I think that's one of the flaws of this bag. But yeah, and because it's so heavy, it has a tendency that if it's not full, it'll flop like that. Like, really, seriously? thankfully, I didn't spend a lot of money on this one. Again, $50 at a flea market here in Sydney. So it opens up like that. It's got a large zip pocket on one side and a phone holder. So you can really tell that this was something from the 2000s, because bags nowadays don't have that. Okay. Yeah, so it's really more the weight of this. And now, if I take it off, so I've got the key right here. And once you take it off, it's really much lighter. Yeah, but I also want to keep it on because it looks cool. So yeah, I guess fashion over function. Okay, and now we get to the final one, which you would have already seen me talk about in the previous video when it talks about why I'm letting this go, and why this is not a bag for me. I don't think that the Mona Lisa pocket at the back is functional. It barely anything fits in there, especially if you are somebody who doesn't want to stretch the leather, then you're probably just going to end up putting your transport card in there. But I don't carry a transport card because I pretty much walk everywhere, and my phone also works as a transport card. I can just tap it on the bus or the train and I'm good to go. Second, I know this is the design of Coco Chanel and that they're never going to change it, but seriously, this love letter pocket here serves no purpose. Nothing fits in there except a receipt, right? And because of this, it's caused scratches on the lambskin and dents on the second flap right there, and scratches as well. Okay. Which is probably why a lot of people would tell you that if you're gonna get the classic flap, get it in the caviar, because the caviar is much more durable. This chain also has caused some dents. I don't know if you can see that where the second flap hits. I can see it right there and right there. So again, lambskin, maybe they could, because my 19 is much more durable than this one. I don't know what kind of coating they have on this lambskin, but if they would apply it on this one, it would probably be much more durable. Okay. So it's got a lot of scratches already. The second flap, while I know it helps to keep the structure of the bag, because if you've seen any of the older vintage ones that have, that are single flap, you would notice that it doesn't have the same structural integrity as this one does, but it doesn't really serve a purpose. If anything, it's an annoyance because it's cumbersome to go into, and that's probably why I end up scratching the bag with my fingernails, is because I keep trying to get in there and, you know, go through the whole thing. So those are the design flaws that I think needs to be addressed, but I know that they're not gonna do it. And look, if you don't like the design, like myself, like if you don't want the love letter pocket, or if you don't want the second flap or the Mona Lisa flap, then perhaps a boy bag is a better alternative, or maybe a Chanel 19, or I think the trendy CC and the Coco handle also has the Mona Lisa pocket at the back, but they don't have the second flap inside. So maybe those would work better for you, or maybe forgo Chanel altogether and go for Saint Laurent, because I mean, I'm personally a fan of Saint Laurent, and I'm actually toying with the idea of getting a Toy Lulu to replace this, but in white with a gold emblem, because I think I need a white bag. But I probably will end up with the YSL monogram clutch instead of the Toy Lulu. Yeah. So yeah, what else? What else in terms of flaws? I think that's pretty much it. Those are the five bags that I feel like could be redesigned better, to be a little bit more functional, to be a little bit more practical. Okay, so thank you, Ron, for tagging me. I am tagging my good friend Kenny from Kenny Ford Alyssa to talk about the flaws of your designer bags, if there are any flaws. I'd also like to tag Kim Curated, and who else? I am bag happy, but I know she's already been tagged by Ron. Who else in my... one second, yeah. Or whoever else wants to do this tag, please go ahead and do so. And I would like you to tag me if you create this video as well. So again, thank you, Ron.